Hello and welcome to the course of Power Transmission Engineering. In this unit, the performance of transmission line, we are going to study about the classification of transmission lines, that means what are the different types of transmission line. We are going to evaluate the performance of this transmission line by determining various parameters like regulation, efficiency, and we will see how the parameters that we have studied in the previous lesson or the previous chapter, and how do we consider these parameters in the lines. Okay, so first of all, performance of transmission line. You know what is a transmission line? So transmission line is nothing but it's a conductor or a group of conductors that are used to transmit power from one point to another point with the help of transmission towers. Suppose you take, this is a transmission tower. And these are the cross arms, and you have insulators here. And high voltage conductors are carrying the power from one point to another point like this. So these conductors are basically called as transmission lines. Okay. So we need to evaluate the performance of this line. So for that, we need to study some basics which are called as efficiency, voltage regulation. Efficiency is defined as the ratio of output power by input power. Okay, or you can also take it as input power is output power plus losses. Suppose this is one end or one point A where you are sending power, and there is another end, say at point B, where you have connected a load. That means the power is received here. So this is called as receiving end. Now the power is transmitted from point A to point B through this line. This is maybe one conductor, or it may be some group of conductors. So this we call it as a transmission line. Okay. Now, what is the power that is at the sending end? So let us take it as PS. This is the power at the receiving end. So let us take it as P. So by transmitting power from point A to point B, there are some losses, some heat losses due to the resistance. There are some losses in this transmission line. So if you subtract those losses from the sending power, you get the power at the receiving end. Now efficiency is defined as the ratio of power at the receiving end upon power at the sending end. But this power at sending end is nothing but equal to power at receiving end plus whatever losses that are associated in the transmission line. Okay, or dissipated in the transmission line. So you can take it as power delivered at receiving end upon power delivered or power supplied at sending end. Okay. So here power that is supplied at sending end is sum of the power delivered at receiving end upon power delivered at receiving end plus losses multiplied. So this can be taken as efficiency. If you want the efficiency in percentage, you have to multiply with 100. P stands for power delivered to the load plus P plus. You can assume that there are three phases, 3 into I square R losses. If you want the percentage, you have to multiply with 100. So this is the formula for calculating the efficiency of a transmission line. Ideally, efficiency should be 100%, but it is not possible. So we have to design or we have to analyze the system such that the efficiency is always near to the 100%. Okay. Next is, the next important factor to study is voltage regulation. All these are fundamentals that are required to understand the performance of transmission line. Okay. So voltage regulation, let us take it as percentage R. So let's see here again. Suppose this is the sending end at point A. Let the voltage at this point or sending end is, let us take it as Vs. And suppose the voltage at this receiving end is Vr. And then you assume that there is one switch here. Okay. Now, when the switch is closed, the power is transmitted from sending end to receiving end. The voltage at the receiving end can be taken as full load voltage. Or you can also call it as rated voltage. Full load voltage or rated voltage is VR, that is, when the switch is closed, what is the voltage at the receiving end is called full load voltage or rated voltage. Now, assume that this switch is suddenly open. This switch is suddenly open. Then, the voltage at this point, the receiving end voltage, will rise instantaneously. Will rise suddenly. This voltage, when the switch is open, let us take it as the voltage is Vr dash. It is the voltage at receiving end at no load. That means when you open the switch, the load is removed. So if the load is removed, the voltage at this point is measured at receiving end, that is Vr dash. So Vr dash is the voltage at the receiving end at no load. Vr is the full load voltage, or you can also call it as rated voltage. Here, therefore, voltage regulation is defined as the ratio of change in voltage from full load to no load when a load is suddenly removed, expressed as a fraction of rated voltage. So this change in the voltage at receiving end upon Vr is called as voltage regulation. If you want it in percentage, you have to multiply with 100. This should be taken when the supply voltage and supply frequency are constant. Okay. So this is voltage regulation. Change in terminal voltage when a load at full load is suddenly removed at constant voltage and frequency is called voltage regulation. Ideally, regulation must be equal to zero. But it is not practically possible. Therefore, the regulation should be maintained as minimum as possible. That means the load voltage should be constant even though it is suddenly removed. Okay. Now, we need further basics. in the coming classes we will be studying that along the length of the transmission line the voltage and current will be in the form of a traveling wave. Suppose this you take as the length. And let us take this as voltage. The voltage at any point, suppose this is point A, this is point B, and this is point C. So the voltage at point A will not be same at any point. Suppose you take along the length of the line, suppose this point here, the change in the voltage or variation in the voltage is more. It will attain the same voltage at again a point C, and again here the voltage will start rising. Okay, so this will propagate, this wave will propagate along the length of the conductor. So here this length you can take it as lambda, where lambda is called wavelength. This we will discuss in detail when we study about the transmission waves. Okay, here this lambda is called wavelength. Now the velocity of this wave, is given by v is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. In physics we have studied velocity is equal to the cycles per second multiplied by wavelength. So here velocity is equal to frequency into wavelength lambda. Clear? So here for in India we have a constant frequency of 50 hertz. So let us substitute that. Similarly substitute velocity 3 into 10 power 8 into lambda. So what you will get, lambda is equal to 6 into 3 into 10 power 8 by 50, that will be equal to 600 kilometers or 6 into 10 power 6 meters. That means this length is equal to 600 kilometers. So here if you take the length is small, suppose the length of transmission line, suppose they assume that this is one tower, this is another tower. Okay, so here assume that this is one tower and this is another tower, and this is the transmission line from this tower to this tower. Now if the length of this transmission line is small, suppose the length is say 20 kilometers or it is less than 200 kilometers. Now that means 20 kilometers means it will come somewhere here, 200 kilometers. So here you can observe that the variation in this voltage along the length, the variation in voltage along this length is minimal. Therefore you can assume that the parameters, that is inductance, capacitance or resistance and conductance, they are assumed to be constant along the length of the line. They are not distributed. You can assume that they are lumped parameters. That is, for less than, and the length is less than 200 kilometers, you can assume that they are, all the transmission parameters are lumped parameters. That means they are lumped at one place in the circuit. Okay. If the length is greater than 200 kilometers, the length of transmission line is greater than 200 kilometers, you have to analyze the performance of transmission line assuming that they are distributed parameters. That means the inductance, capacitance and the resistance are distributed throughout the length of the line. These are the fundamentals that are required for analyzing the performance of transmission line. Okay. Now let us see further. There are four parameters that are there in the analysis of transmission line which you have seen in the previous unit. What are they? One is the series resistance. R, which is given by rho L by A. Another parameter is series inductance, which is due to the magnetic flux linkages between the conductors that are carrying current. So this is denoted by L and this is the symbol for inductance. This is because of the property of the material. Resistance is because of the property of the material used for transmission line, for the transmission line conductor. Third one is capacitance. It is denoted by C. So here you can see there are two lines or three lines that are at different voltages. So whenever there are two lines at different instantaneous voltage, there will be a capacitance between these two lines that is distributed throughout the length of this conductor. There will be a capacitance between these two lines. That means it is there, it is present in shunt or it is present in parallel. So let us take this as C. C stands for capacitance. Now, there can be also a capacitance between the high voltage line and the ground also. Okay, but as of now we are neglecting this effect of ground. Okay, so here you can see there are number of capacitors that are connected in parallel and are distributed throughout the length of the line. Okay, so you can see here C. Suppose you want to calculate what is the charging current through these capacitors, C. The charging current is IC, is given by the charging current IC is given by the voltage upon the impedance. So here it is V into omega into C. Okay, so here you can see the capacitor charging current is proportional to voltage and is also proportional to C, because omega is constant, frequency is constant, omega is angular frequency which is equal to 2 pi f is constant. So if the voltage is high, that means the transmission line voltage is high, then the charging current will be there. That means the effect of capacitance has to be considered. Okay, or you can see that the capacitor is distributed throughout the length of the line. That means if the length of the line is more, that is more capacitors are added in parallel. So in parallel combination, we know as the number of capacitors increase, the value of capacitance will increase. So if the length of the line is more, capacitance is more, the charging current can be taken as proportional to length. So what is the important point to be considered here is, you have to assume the value of capacitance. Consider, you have to consider the capacitance parameter for determining the performance of transmission line in two conditions. One is the voltage is very high, other one is the length of the transmission line is also high. If the voltage is less and the length of transmission line is less, the charging current is less and you can neglect the effect of this shunt parameter capacitance. But here, whenever the voltage is high and the capacitance is high, you cannot neglect the effect of capacitance. So this is the symbol for capacitance, C. There is one more parameter called conductance, G. So how conductance will come in the transmission line? So here we have seen in this transmission towers. So this transmission towers, these are the cross arms, and you have insulators here like this. And to these insulators, there is a high voltage line which is connected. Now what happens is, through these insulators, a small leakage current will flow through this. A small leakage current like this through the insulators will flow. Okay? This effect of leakage current can be taken as a shunt parameter as the conductance G. Okay? So there are four parameters in the transmission line. One is the series parameter, other one is the shunt parameters. In series parameters, you can take the resistance and inductance as series parameters and capacitance and conductance as shunt parameters. Okay. But however, in determining the performance, we can see that the leakage currents are negligible and therefore the effect of conductance is usually neglected. Whatever may be the operating voltage or whatever may be the length of the line, we do not consider the effect of this fourth parameter, conductance. However, we will consider the effect of R, L, and C based on the operating voltages and based on the length of the transmission line. So here, let us see how to classify the transmission lines based on the length and operating voltage. There are three categories of transmission lines based on the length and the operating voltage of the transmission line. Okay. So let us see what are they. Classification of transmission lines. The first category is called short transmission line. In the short transmission line, the length of the transmission line is less than 80 kilometers and the operating voltage is less than 20 kilovolts. So when the length of the transmission line is less than 80 kilometers and the operating voltage V is less than 20 kilovolts, it is called as a short transmission line. You can represent a short transmission line like this. There is a resistance and an inductance like this. So this is R, this is XL. XL is given by 2 pi F into L in ohms. Because L is having units of entry, you have to convert it into ohms. This is the sending end voltage Vs. This is the sending end current Is. Receiving end voltage IR, receiving end current IR, receiving end voltage VS. Here you can see the effect of capacitance is neglected. Why? Because we have seen the charging current is proportional to voltage and capacitance, that is proportional to length. So here the length is small. And also, the voltage is also small, so charging current is negligible. The effect of the shunt capacitance can be neglected. Here R and L are resistance and inductance per phase, also per unit length, that means per kilometer like that. Okay. Clear? This is the next type of transmission line is medium transmission line. In medium transmission line, the length of the transmission line is between 80 kilometers to 200 kilometers, and the operating voltage is between 20 kilovolts to 100 kilovolts. In some textbooks, you may find it as 160 kilometers. It hardly makes any difference. There is no particular rule to take the length of the transmission line. All these conventions are basically done to minimize the errors in calibration of voltage regulation and efficiency. Okay, so length is taken as 200 kilometers maximum length, and minimum length is 80 kilometers. You can call it as a medium transmission line. And here the operating voltage is in between 20 kV and 100 kV. Here the effect of the capacitance cannot be neglected. Why? Because the charging current is significant. That means the length is also more and the voltage is also more. Therefore, the effect of capacitance cannot be neglected. But however, you can assume the capacitance to be a lumped parameter, because the length of the transmission line is only 200 kilometers. It can be assumed to be lumped at one point rather than distributed over the entire length. So capacitance can be assumed to be lumped, and it cannot be neglected. Yeah. And here in medium transmission line, there are two configurations available. One is called as a nominal T method. And another one is a nominal pi method. So these are two methods that are used to analyze the performance of the medium transmission lines. So in a nominal T method, the series impedance is divided into half between the sending end and receiving end, whereas the shunt capacitance is assumed to be lumped at the center. As the symbol indicates clearly, it can be seen that as the symbol indicates clearly, it is in the shape of a T. So this is called as a nominal T method. So here, this is the sending end voltage Vs, sending end current Is. This is receiving end voltage Vr. This is receiving end current Ir. And this is receiving end voltage Vr. Series impedance is divided into two halves, whereas the shunt admittance is taken lumped at the center. Here you can assume this current is Ic and the voltage is V dash across the capacitor. This type of a configuration is called nominal T method. Next we see nominal pi method. Nominal pi method. Here, the series impedance is taken at the center, whereas the shunt admittances are divided into two halves for the sending end and the receiving end. Suppose this is sending end voltage Vs, sending end current Is, receiving end voltage Vr, receiving end current Ir. This is the series. impedance. This is the capacitor at the receiving end. There is capacitor of half admittance at the sending end. So this is Y by 2. This is also Y by 2. This is a nominal pi method to analyze the performance of transmission line. Clear? The last one is long transmission line. For the long transmission line, the length is greater than 200 kilometers and the operating voltage is greater than 100 kV. Okay. So here, you cannot neglect any parameter. You have to assume R, L, and C are the three parameters. And also, all these three parameters are not lumped. They are distributed along the length of the transmission line. So here, the equivalent circuit will look like this. This is a resistance, series, resistance and inductance, series, resistance and inductance. So all these will be distributed along the length of the transmission line, like this. So here, you can take this is the sending end voltage Vs, this is sending end current Is, this is an impedance Z. So all the shunt parameters also like capacitance, they are distributed throughout the length of the conductor. This is receiving end current IR. Okay. So this is how the transmission lines are classified. There are three types: short transmission line, medium transmission line, and long transmission line. To summarize, short transmission line means the length is less than 80 kilometers, operating voltage is less than 10 kilovolts or 20 kilovolts. Medium transmission line, the operating voltage is in between 20 kilovolts to 100 kilovolts, but the length is between 80 kilometers to 200 kilometers. A long transmission line where the operating voltage is greater than 100 kV and the length of the transmission line is more than 200 kilometers. So this is the types of three transmission lines. We will analyze these circuits in detail in the coming classes. Thank you.